Kolumka, Totomono, Suntini, Tipramo Honi Huite, Kaisha Press Conference Organized Kaikia, Ang Pilano Nakarsano, Tini the Nine Eight of Nairo, Taisini the Lukurovno, Karon, Ang Tini Bunikok Bashe, Kok Sanai, Karon the Kok by Sanam, Nangoamo, Tabuk, Winiboroni Bagibok, Hananang. Since government was an issue for a cox hanai, borna a big hanai, Amnibagi, the cock by Buzi Mano, a common something used hanai. Into airport, Sini Okra Rock, the senior members of Tombayo, Boro, Cock Borok by address day, Savan. First of all, we would like to thank the members of press and our who has been who is present here and the senior members who is present here, Mr. Sridham Deparma, who is in my left, Mr. Ananto Deparma, who is my right, and from our young members and volunteers very actively participating in our all works and processing in this one in COVID 19 lockdown, and especially as Bhubagra is not here, and I will be the hosting. I will be hosting the press conference for. Okay. First of all, there is a press article on 5th and 21st July, no, 5th and 21st April, sorry, April. Two articles have been published in Shandun Patrika as well as in Pratyaksha Tibura that our organization and Bhubagra is not doing anything for the common people during this period of lockdown. And people are asking for his help, but Maharaja has disappeared according to their article. And we want to clarify this, that this is a totally misleading, fake and politically influenced article which has been written by those those newspapers. Because we all know that since from the early days of lockdown, our organization and Bhubagra are tremendously working for the poor, especially for the poor in rural areas, in terms of providing food, in terms of providing other essential commodities, and as well as not only in our state, in outside state also. Till now, our Bhubagra has contributed at least 25 lakhs out of his own pocket, and still there are some people who are questioning about his achievements or questioning about his works, and we strongly condemn such type of article. Is totally trying to harm and hurt the reputation of our Maharaja, and we as a member of Tipra want to say that after the lockdown period is over, we will going to strike a serious legal action against those newspapers. We have already filed an FIR against Shandun Patrika and Pratyaksha Tripura. Second issue is that there is a an issue which needs to be redressed as early as possible, because there is a according to us, there is a one recruitment notification by TPSC for the Tripura Forest Service, which is a grade 1 post or grade 2 post, group A gazetted post. In that newspaper, in this recruitment, it is said that a desirable qualification is sought from the Bengali speaking people. And now we would like to share our views that this regulation, this notification itself is a violation of the Officious Language Act 1963 as well as the principle of equal representation, because we have a two official languages in our state. So if you have to give some kind of qualification or desirable qualification, you have to put both the languages at the same time, because if you are doing that, you are making a kind of this partiality to the Bengali speaking language, and also it's a violative of the Article 21 of our constitution, because everybody has a right for representation as well as the language, which is a official language of our state, has to be given respect, has to be given the proper chance to be carried out in every sphere of our official purposes or works. In this particular recruitment, which is advertise number 4 or 2020, which is published by the TPSC in newspaper, for the post of Tripura Forest Service under the GA, General Administration Department. In this recruitment, there are total post of 6, and out of that, 3 are reserved for the general category, 2 are reserved for the SC category, and 1 is for ST category, which is totally wrong and totally illegal in our point of view. Because according to, if you follow the roster point, roster parameter of our state, the division of post has to be 3 for general, 2 for ST candidates, and 1 for SC candidates. We strongly demand that such cancellation of the notification and re-notify it after maintaining and after following the correct and accurate roster roster parameters of our state. And earlier also there has been several occasions in where this roster phase or roster parameters have not been followed. During the time of previous government, there has been a series of malpractice by the TPSC as well as the concerned official department in following or giving the government post, securing the government post, and there are series of bad luck posts are still in waiting to be filled up by the state government. We came to know that more than 30,000 posts are still in a backlog category. So we demand from our state government as well as the concerned government and to the chairman of TPSC itself that kindly re-notify all those backlogs post and cancellation of this present recruitment advertisement, which I have been mentioning earlier. And in related to this matter, we want to request the Chief Minister itself, the Forest Minister, that kindly take these issues as soon as possible to be followed in according to the law. And sometimes we do not intend to harm any reputation, but to express that there are ministers, MP, MLAs from the Scheduled Tribe category, and we specially request to those, please do something and do some fruitful measures should be taken regarding this recruitment guidelines, regarding this discrimination of official languages. And we hope that in future this kind of discrimination will not happen. And finally, we want to redress an issue which is most important for today's press conference, which is we all know that in Kanchanpur district, this MISO convention and one Nagarik Suraksha Manch, Nagarik Suraksha Manch has been under hunger strike. It's been 5 days to 6 days, still continuing. We want to ask the state government that how, during this period of national disaster authority as in force, how they can protest or unite or doing this kind of demonstration which is totally impermissible during this period of crisis. We strongly believe that this kind of attitude will lead to nothing. It will create the division between our Tiprasa people as well as the other indigenous groups of Northeast. And this is totally, in our point of view, is totally an act of racial discrimination. What I'm trying to say, it's a favor to certain type of this community, because we know that they are totally against this Bru settlement issue. Then there are earlier also there has been lots of protest regarding this matter by the Bru people as well as in the non-speaking Bengali people as well as the Mizo people. So through this press conference, we want to say that, and most of all, we want to urge to our Mizo brothers and sisters of Jompu Hill and who are staying in Kanchanpur area, that we believe there are strong evil minds and ill-minded people are working behind the curtains, behind all this act of these demonstrations and whatever this hunger strike is going on. Because last time when there is a bandh in strike in which for this CAB and CA protest, we also show that there is a violence in Kanchanpur area. And most of them are, they are in dark because they are not coming forward to raise their voice, because they are playing a dirty game to remain in dark and to giving forward to the innocent minds. And we also believe that the Mizo people are becoming prey to those evil minds, because they have no respect for any indigenous committee of Northeast, no respect for our Tiprasa people, or nor against any integrity, unity and brotherhood of among the Tiprasa people of our state. We strongly appeal to our Mizo brothers that please get rid of all these evil-minded people, so that we can go through a peaceful dialogue, or whatever is there any is there any appeal which you want to address to us, or we can sit together in peacefully and we'll discuss how to how to make success the whole process of brew settlement issues, because we believe that this land also belong to the Mizo people as well as the Brew people. We consider ourselves as a brothers, and we do not want any kind of conflict, any kind of discrimination among ourselves. I want to request specially the Mizo Convention, the officials of Mizo Conventions, to do some fruitful work so that these kind of attitudes, this kind of mentality, and this kind of discrimination against human to human, against tribe to tribe, is not happen. If you want to have any dialogues with our Bhuvagra, with our organization, please feel free and come forward and talk to us, because this issue has been pending for 23 years. There has been a tremendous misery and suffering faced by our Brew people, which had been a disaster, literally a disaster for them. And after 23 years, this issue have been finally settled. We do thank the central government as well as the state government to make success the whole process, and we will and I hope our government is also doing his best to resettle the Brew people across the state of Tripura. And we want to convey a message to our Brew people also. Please do not feel isolated or do not feel alone, because the entire Tripura people are with you. We have welcomed the agreement which has been signed in New Delhi, the tripartite agreement that claiming to be resettled the Brew people in our state with full facilities provided by the government, and we'll try our level best to make it success in a true sense possible. I would further like to add that since few days back, our brother, Mr. Dr. Pachuau, has claimed, they had said that Maharaja is a very, in social media, that Maharaja is against Mizo people, he is the most communal, and blah blah blah, like which is totally unacceptable for anyone. Especially we condemn the whole process, the dialogue which have been said by this Dr. Pachuau. And we also know that on the very next day he had personally sought apology to our Bhuvagra, and Bhuvagra told us that please, he had sought apology to me, so please do not take any other action against them. So we accept the apology, and for this, and we would like to convey a message that out of generosity of our Bhuvagra, we accept this kind of apology. But it is not that in future, if such kind of act repeats again, we will not going to tolerate, and we will take strong legal steps against those who will try to malign the reputation, stature, and hurt the reputation of our Bhuvagra Maharaja Pradyut Kishun. And there are some other incidents also we would like to address, that on 17th of May 2020, we all know there is an incident in Nandanagar which leads to an fight between two communities regarding the matter of selling vegetables by our Tiprasa in that area. And most surprisingly, I really wonder that is there any law and order in our state that who are doing to make peace or who are helping the victims, they are being charged with false FIR, and the culprit who make the incident happen, who threatened our people, who indulge in fighting, and given this kind of hatred speech in this incident, are away from police procedures. So we also like to request our government that please withdraw all those charges, all those FIRs which is lodged against three Tiprasa people whose names are Anthony Debarma and Rajesh Debarma and Torun Debarma, because they are involved in any kind of riot or violation of peace or creating any discrimination or disputes among the people of our Tiprasa, among the people of our Bengali. They are just helping the the vegetable sellers over there, because they are there has been a serious threat to those people, because since few days back there has been an issue, there has been a burning issue of this topic of protesting the Tiprasa people to not to sell the vegetables in that particular area. So we condemned such type of act, and we appeal to our Chief Minister as well as the government that please take immediate true steps so that the actual culprit may be or put behind the bars. And finally, we would like to show our gratitude, our thanks, who are working day and night, who are working 24/7 to fight this coronavirus, because we all know the whole humanity is fighting for it. And we would like to thank our doctors, our police personnel and healthcare staff who are involving fight with this coronavirus in our state. And we would like to offer our heartfelt gratitude to those who are involved in this process. Now I would like to I will request our senior member address our senior members of our organization, Mr. Ananto Debarma. Please, if you have any views, please share, which is we believe is a very important issue. We came to know that from our volunteers as well as our workers from Kanchanpur and the nearby places of our North Tripura, that our Mizo people is under a wrong impression that if the Bru people are got settlement in that Kanchanpur area or in Joku Hill area, their land, their culture, their tradition will be lost. Their land will be snatched away by these Bru people, and there will be a communal conflict. Or I say there will be a conflict between Mizos and Bro people. Now we want to clearly say our views that not a single land of our Mizo people is under any threat, neither their culture, neither their tradition. They have full right to practice, they have full right to be there in Jompui Hill. And no one, especially can curtail or no one can take away the rights of our Mizo people. And we want to assure our Mizo brothers also that the entire Tiprasa are peace loving people, and there will be no conflict between the Mizos in Mizos and Tiprasa people or Bro people or Mizo, between Bro people and Mizo people. And we have a deep respect towards this Mizo community, Mizo people, Mizo brothers and sisters, and we hope that you will think and you will welcome the procedure, the whole resettlement process of our Bro people in Kanchanpur as well as the other parts of our country for resettlement. And finally, I would like to, before ending, I would like to pay my regards, I would like to show my deep condolences and my heartfelt respect to the 20 brave souls of our Indian Army who have been martyred in a few days back in a fight with Chinese Army in Galwan district of Ladakh, and we are very much in sorrow for the loss of our country has, and as well as we show our deep condolences, deep respect for the family who have lost their ones, and this in this situation, we the members of Tipra are whole and wholehearted to support the. This government, this government to take some steps immediately, so that the departed, so that the souls, the brave souls, got justice. That their souls, their lives is not been wiped out or is not been given unnecessarily. Okay. So I think I have covered all these points what I want to raise, and as our senior members have introduced ourselves, and I would like to again introduce Minister Sridham Devarma. He is a senior member of our Tipra organization. When you know that Maharaja Pradyut is the chairman of our society, and I am Advocate Arup Devarma, in charge of a secretary to this organization. And Mr. Ananta Devarma also, he is a senior member of our organization and a member of executive committee of our Tipra organization. So now it's all okay. We are concluding this press conference, and if you have any kind of question, if you have any type of question which you want to put, you can ask me, you can ask our senior also. Is there any question if you have, so we are ready to answer it.